How's everyone doing?
Well, if you're ready to rock and roll, I need to see your best rock and roll face on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three. Rock and roll face! Nice! That was awesome, you guys! So welcome to Garage Rock / Emo Week here at Kid Row. And before we get started, you guys know the drill by now. We need to take a quick rock and roll call. So, when I call your name, I need to see your fists go up in the air and I need you to say, Cement Mixers! Alright, let's give it a try on three. One, two, three, Cement Mixers! Nice! That was awesome, you guys! So remember, open up your ears and listen for your name. Can we hear it from Aya? Hi, Aya! Now let's give it up for Besso! Hi, Besso! Now can we hear it from Daisy? Hi, Daisy! Now can we have Jagger in the house? Hi, Jagger! Now let's hear it from Ozzy! Hi, Ozzy! Now let's give it up for Serene the Dream! Hi, Serene! Now do we have a Teo in the house? Hi, Teo! And last, but certainly not least, let's give it up for Waylon! Hi, Waylon! Awesome job, you guys! Well, now that we know that everyone's here, let's get to rockin' and rollin'.
Hey, Kid Rowers, are you ready to play a game? Oh, thanks, I love my hair too. All right, so we're gonna play Hey Johnny Walker as a freeze dance. So at the end, when I say, do your thing and stop, you're gonna do your thing and stop. The first thing you're gonna do is stick out your tongue like, so do your thing and stop. Okay, you ready? Let's do it. Hey, Johnny Walker, walking down the street. Didn't know what to do, so he stopped in front of me and said, hey, boy, do your thing, do your thing. Hey, boy, do your thing and stop. Very good. Now, for the next gesture, for this freeze, I want you to do, like, buck teeth, right? Like, do your thing and stop. Can you guys practice that? One, two, three. Good. You guys look so silly. I love it. All right, you ready? Little Johnny Walker walking down the street. Didn't know what to do, so he stopped in front of me and said, hey, boy, do your thing, do your thing. Hey, boy, do your thing and stop. Very good. Those are like rabbit buck teeth. I love it. All right, this time I want you to make your best rock and roll face ever in the world. You got to practice it first. Ready? I'm going to do mine and you do yours on three. One, two, three. How about another one? Good. All right, you ready? Little Sally Walker walking down the street. Didn't know what to do, so she stopped in front of me and said, hey girl, do your thing, do your thing. Hey girl, do your thing and stop. I can't do it with a pick in my hand. There we go. Now I drop my pick. All right. For the last one, I want you to do a spin and then your best rock and roll face. Can you guys do that? I bet you can. All right, you ready? Little Johnny Walker walking down the street. Didn't know what to do, so he stopped in front of me and said, hey boy, do your thing, do your thing. Hey boy, do your thing and stop. Whoa, rock and rollers in the house. Good job, guys. Hope you had fun doing the Johnny Walker freeze dance. Peace.
Hey, Cement Mixers. Who's ready for a little hey lolly? Awesome, let's hit it. One, two, three, four. Hey lolly, lolly, lolly. Hey lolly, lolly, oh. Hey lolly, lolly, lolly. Hey lolly, lolly, oh. This is a silly kind of song. Hey lolly, lolly, oh. You make it up as you go along. Hey lolly, lolly, oh. Hey, Aya, Aya, Aya. Hey, Aya, Aya, oh. Hey, Aya, Aya, Aya. Daisy, Daisy. Hey, Daisy, Daisy, oh. Hey, Jagger, Jagger, Jagger. Hey, Jagger, Jagger, oh. Hey, Jagger, Jagger, Jagger. Hey, Jagger, Jagger, oh. Hey, Ozzy, Ozzy, Ozzy. Hey, Ozzy, Ozzy, oh. Hey, Ozzy, Ozzy, Ozzy. Hey, Ozzy, Ozzy, oh. Hey, Serene, Serene, Serene. Hey, Serene, Serene, oh. Hey, Serene, Serene, Serene. Oh, hey, Serene, oh. Hey, Tail, Tail, Tail. Hey, Tail, Tail. Hey, Tail, Tail, Tail. Hey, Tail, Tail. Hey, Waylon, Waylon, Waylon. Hey, Waylon, Waylon, oh. Hey, Waylon, Waylon, Waylon. Hey, Waylon, Waylon, oh. Hey, Lolly, Lolly, Lolly. Hey, Lolly, Lolly, oh. Hey, Lolly, Lolly, Lolly. Hey, Lolly, Lolly, oh. Awesome. Good job, guys. Keep on rocking.
Hey, Kid Rowerooskies. It's time for a little brief recap on what we learned a couple weeks back, which is dynamics. I'll give you a hint what dynamics is. Dynamics! Yeah, it's when you start off really soft and then you get loud. So let's try a dynamic of I love Neil's pink hair. Ready? I love Neil's pink hair! Pink hair! Don't care! All right, team, let's do a little brief recap on stage presence. Stage presence is the way you present yourself on stage. So if you're kind of like this, then that's how you're presenting yourself. That's not very good stage presence. But if you're like, yeah, I'm here, I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna play instruments, that's great stage presence. So, for example, if you're singing, you're using the microphone a little bit close to your mouth, like about that far apart, and you're singing directly into the mic. And you can look the audience and you can raise your hand up, you can do whatever you want, but you're moving and having fun, 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 fun. If you're playing guitar, you're rocking out, having a blast, bass, drums, you're crashing, you're going nuts, you're having fun. You guys can make lots of rock and roll faces like, grr, and or you could just be smiling and having a good time. The way we present ourselves on stage is stage presence, and we want great stage presence, which means we need to have tons of fun with our friends on stage. All right, good job, team. Here's another recap for you. Let's talk about tempo. Does anyone remember what tempo is? Right, it's the speed of the song. So the beat and the rhythm is going like, and that's the tempo, that speed. Now this is a different tempo. And this is a different tempo. So the drummer is always gonna count you in with the tempo when they're saying one and two and three, or they're gonna be like one, two, three, four. That's how you'll know what tempo you're playing in. Okay, let's do a little recap on song form. Song form is the way the song is laid out. So you start off usually in a song with an intro, which is the introduction of the song, which is usually some music or something. Then you go into the verse, which tells the story. Then you go to the chorus, which repeats itself and is the catchiest, hookiest part of the song usually. And then you go to another verse, another chorus. And eventually you get to a bridge, which bridges you from one part of the song to the next, to the end. And then you have either the last verse or the last chorus or whatever, however the song ends. Song form is the different parts of a song. Okay, little rockers, here's the deal. We are gonna now talk about a vocab word. So this week's vocab word is genre. And genre sounds French, but it's not, I don't think. But anyway, genre is like the different categories that music is in. So some songs kind of fit in more than one category, but a lot of times each category, each section, each group has a certain sound and a certain quality to it that makes it that particular thing. For example, country music sounds different than rap music. They're two different genres. One is country and one is rap, and they don't really sound the same. Now, once in a while, a country artist might use some rap, or a rap artist might use some country, but typically they're pretty separate and they're in their own category. Other categories or genres are rock and roll, pop, folk, R&B, jazz, just to name a few. Well, five in particular. Can you guys say genre? Ooh, oui, oui, you do sound French. Good job, guys.
Sing with me. All right, band. It's 2000s week here. We got the White Stripes, Seven Nation Army, one of the ultimate riffs of all time. Sing along and play along. Here we go. One.
Today, class, we are going to have a music history lesson. So today's music history lesson is all about garage rock and emo bands. So garage rock was when basic chord patterns would happen in songs and the bands would kind of come together and they would traditionally play out of their garage. It was usually a bunch of friends after school, get together, go in someone's garage and pick up their instruments and start playing songs and making up songs together. And those were kind of how garage rock started. And some examples of garage rock are the White Stripes, the Strokes, the Black Keys, and the Yeah Yeah Yeahs. Now for emo, emo rock was, the word emo comes from emotion or emotional. So the lyrics of the song had a very emotional, confessional kind of thing where people were talking about their feelings in their songs. And that kind of happened in mostly in the early 2000s. Emo became a thing. This wig is a little bit emo. Not that it's a wig, it's my real hair. Let's be honest. People, when they dressed emo, the boys wore a lot of eyeliner and had their hair down in their face a little bit and kind of like wore jackets like this. And that was just kind of the look and that was what people did. Some emo bands that you might have heard of is Panic at the Disco or Good Charlotte or Jimmy Eat World, which you might be hearing a little more from today. I'm just having a feeling. And that's your music history lesson for today.
Band up on your feet, it's time to sing and dance. Repeat after me. It just takes some time. Go.
them. So let's go over the notes that we are dealing with. We are dealing with A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. And then we go right back around to A and start all over. Go to right in the middle of the keyboard, find the pair of two black notes right in front of me, and then we step down one, we find our middle C. Can we all say that? Middle C. Awesome, good job. Our middle C, if we walk up 8 steps, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, we find C again. That is called an octave. Can we say that together? Octave. Awesome. An octave is 8 notes. Awesome. So from C to C is an octave. That's awesome. Keep on rocking, guys.
All right, you guys. Now we're gonna do a quick recap of the guitar. Now, one more time, how many strings does a guitar have? Does it have 10,100? Nah. Does it have 20,098? No. It's got, let's count it together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 strings. Now, each string has its own name, depending on what note they play. And those names are E, A, D, G, B, and E. And here at Kid Row, we have a way of remembering those names. And that is Eddie, 8, Dynamite, Good, Bye, Eddie. All right, so can we say that all together? Here we go. Eddie, 8, Dynamite, Good, Bye, Eddie. Good job, you guys. Now, does anyone remember what these little sections here are called? It's okay if you don't remember it. Don't fret about it.
I might have given a little hint there.
Now, these guys are called frets. Can you all say frets? Nice! Now, when you push down on one of these frets, it changes the pitch or the note of the string. So, this is the E string. And then, watch as the note changes. Sounds pretty cool, right? Now, do we all remember how to count our frets? You count them starting from up here. So this is fret 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on and so forth. So if I wanted to find fret number 8, let's go figure that out. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There it is, fret number 8. Now let's say if I wanted to play fret number 5. Let's start from the top here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right there. There's your fret number 5. Good job, you guys. So one more time, this is the guitar. Now let's move on to your next activity.
Hey guys, what's going on? Do you remember what this thing's called? That's right, it's the drum set. Now we're gonna do some ear training. Since you know all about it, you guys have been practicing and learning about the drums for the past few weeks, and now we're gonna do some ear training. What's ear training? It's when you train your ear so you can remember what everything sounds like without even thinking about it. All right, so I'm gonna play each one of these drums. You're gonna close your eyes and you're gonna tell me what drum it is. All right, you ready? Close your eyes. Here we go. All right, open your eyes. What drum was that? That's right, it was the snare drum. Very good. All right, close your eyes again. Here we go. Open your eyes. What drum was that? That's right, it was the tom. The what tom, though? There's two toms, the brothers. Very good, it was the rack tom. And why is it a rack tom? Because it sits on a rack. drum is this. Did you peek? That's right, it's the floor tom. And why is it the floor tom? Because it sits on a floor. I tell you, the guy who came up with this was a genius. All right, let's move on to our cymbals. We have one more drum, but we're gonna get to that at the end. You guys ready? Close your eyes, no peeking. Here we go. What cymbal is that? That's right, it's the hi-hat. It'd make for a very uncomfortable hat, but very fashionable. All right, moving on, here we go. Holy cow, what cymbal was that? One more time, close your eyes, no peeking. Can you take a guess? That's right, it was the crash cymbal, and it's the crash cymbal because it's extra loud. Here we go, moving on, close your eyes. What cymbal is that? That's right, it's the ride cymbal because you cruise on the ride cymbal. Very good. All right, one more drum. Close your eyes. Here we go. What drum is that? One more time. All right, take a guess. That's right, it's the kick drum. Why is it the kick drum? Cause you kick it, dog. Very good. All right, you guys are awesome. We'll see you next week.
Hey, rock stars. We are gonna do a little recap of the la 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 voice. All right, who's ready? Awesome. So, I'm gonna need everyone who remembers to just shout it out. What is the first thing we do when we're getting ready to sing? Very good, we warm up. Why is it important to warm up? It's important to warm up so we get our voice loose and awake and ready to do gymnastics. Awesome, if we're gonna do some backflips with our voice, we need to stretch and make sure that we're warm so we don't hurt ourselves. A great way to warm up is doing a little 5-note scale. Like meow, 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 meow. Meow, 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 meow. Can you do it with me? Awesome. 1, 2, 3, 4. Meow, 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 meow. Meow, 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 meow. Very good. 5-note scales and easy singing is a great way to warm up so we don't hurt ourselves. Then once we're a little more warm, we can dive right in to singing the real stuff. Awesome. So I need all of you, when this is over, pick your favorite song and put it on and maybe sing it with it or sing it a cappella. A cappella means no music behind you, but just making music with your voice. Awesome, guys. Keep on singing. You're doing a great job.
Hey, kid rowers, we're about to learn about a new instrument. It might not be super new to you because you've probably seen it in our rehearsal space and you've probably seen me or someone else playing it. Maybe even you've played it. But does anyone know what this is? Nope, it's not an electric guitar. You're close though.
Whoa.
Yeah, it's a bass guitar or a bass. So there's something different about the bass guitar versus an electric guitar that you can see right away.
Let's look up close. Let's count how many strings there are. 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many strings are usually in a regular guitar?
Right, 6. So a bass has 4. Now here's something very interesting. These letters of these strings are the same as the first 4 string letters of a guitar. You have your E for Eddie, your A for 8, your D for dynamite, and your G for goodbye. But you don't have your B and your E at the end. Goodbye, Eddie. But you have your E, A, D, G. And those are your strings. What else do you notice that's similar with this in a guitar? Yeah, we have frets. We have all the different parts of the neck of the bass has frets on it, and the different frets are gonna sound different. Now, what about these thingamabobbers up here? Are they just like little keys that you turn for fun? No, they're for tuning. You tune the guitar or the bass by turning these different ways. I'm not gonna throw it out of tune. The rule of thumb is you only touch these when you first are gonna pick up your guitar or your bass to play. You don't just play with them just for fun whenever you feel like it. This is the bass. Ta-da!
All right, you guys, now we're gonna go over how to play your song, Hey Mickey, on the bass. So your first note is E, your second note is E, your third note is A, and your fourth note is B. So you play your E note twice as much as you play your A and your B. So with that in mind, here's how you play it. So first you want your open E string. That means plucking this this string right here without pressing down any frets. And you're gonna pluck that four times. One, two, three, four. And then you're gonna put your finger and you're gonna put it on this fifth fret right here of the E string. And you're gonna hit that two times. And then you're gonna slide on down to the seventh fret and pluck that two times. One, two. So all together, it's the E four times. One, two, three, four. And then it's your fifth fret, which is your A, two times. One, two, and then slide on down to the seventh fret and hit that two times, that's your B. One, two. So all together, it's gonna sound like this. One, two, three, four. One, two, one, two. One more time, it's gonna be one, two, three, four, one, two, one, two. All right, you guys ready to try that all together? All right, so everyone grab onto your basses, grab on real tight, and put your fingers on your E string and get ready to pluck it, all right? Here we go, I'm gonna count us in, so wait for my counting. Here we go. One, two, here we go. E, 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 and A, A, B, B. E, 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 and A, and B, B. Nice job, you guys. So with the lyrics of your song, it should sound something like this. Here we go. Oh, Mickey, what a pity you don't understand. I'll take you by the heart if you take me by the hand. Oh, Mickey, you're so pretty, can't you understand? It's guys like you, Mickey. Oh, what you do, Mickey, don't break my heart, Mickey. Good job, you guys. So are you guys ready to try that all together? All right, here we go. Everyone grab onto your bass and put your finger on that E string, boom, and get ready to play together with the lyrics of your song. Here we go. One, two, ready, go. Oh, Mickey, what a pity you don't understand. I take you by the heart if you take me by the hand. Oh, Mickey, you're so pretty, can't you understand? It's guys like you, Mickey. Oh, what you do, Mickey, don't break my heart, Mickey. Nice job, you guys. And then the best part, that's all the notes you need to know, because in the next section, all you're doing is just chanting and clapping along. So after you sing, oh, Mickey, you're so fine, you blow my mind, hey, Mickey, hey, Mickey. And you chant that four times, and then you go in with your bass part, all right? You guys ready to try that all together? So one more time, you're gonna do this chant, oh, Mickey, you're so fine, you blow my mind, hey, Mickey, hey, Mickey. You're gonna do that four times, and then you're gonna go into that chorus section with your bass line. All right, you guys ready to try that all together? All right, here we go. And I'm gonna count us off. Remember, we're gonna clap and chant first, okay? Four times. Here we go. One, two, here we go. Oh, Mickey, you're
you're so fine, you're so fine, you blow my mind. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Oh, Mickey, you're so fine, you're so fine, you blow my mind. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Oh, Mickey, you're so fine, you're so fine, you blow my mind. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Oh, Mickey, you're so fine, you're so fine, you blow my mind. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Oh, Mickey, what a pity you don't understand. I take you by the heart if you take me by the hand. Oh, Mickey, you're so pretty, can't you understand? It's guys like you, Mickey. Oh, what you do, Mickey, don't break my heart, Mickey. Good job, you guys. And that's how you play Hey, Mickey on the bass.
All right, let's do one of my favorite songs. It's the Avocado song. So first, we're gonna use dynamics for doing this. So that means we're gonna start off soft and then we're gonna get louder and louder as it goes. And we're gonna also use our stage presence to show our body. So we're gonna start by picking avocados. And then at the end when we go guacamole, guac, guacamole, we're gonna go nuts, okay? Maybe we should add nuts to the song. All right, you ready? First, you pick avocados, pick avocados, then you pick avocados, pick avocados, then you slice avocados, slice avocados, then you slice avocados, slice avocados, then you mash avocados, mash avocados, then you mash avocados, mash avocados, then you guacamole, guac guacamole, then you guacamole, guac guacamole. Serious face. Hard to have a serious face with pink hair. Next up, we are gonna go bananas. So first, we pick bananas, then we pick bananas, then we slice bananas, then we slice bananas, then we mash bananas, then we mash bananas, then we go bananas, go bananas, then we go bananas, go bananas. Serious face. Not serious enough. Much better. Next up, we're gonna sauce some apples. How do you sauce some apples? First, you pick the apples. Pick the apples. Then you pick the apples. Pick the apples. Then you slice the apples. Slice the apples. Then you slice the apples. Slice the apples. Then you mash the apples. Mash the apples. Then you mash the apples. Mash the apples. Then you sauce the apples. Sauce the apples. Applesauce the apples. Sauce the apples. Next up, we need something to wash this all down with. I prefer a nice cold glass of lemonade. So to make lemonade, first you need some sugar. Okay, and a little water. Then you pick the lemons, pick the lemons, then you pick the lemons, pick the lemons, then you slice the lemons, slice the lemons, then you slice the lemons, slice the lemons, then you squeeze the lemons, squeeze the lemons, then you squeeze the lemons, squeeze the lemons, then you aid the lemons, lemonade the lemons, then you aid the lemons, lemonade the lemons. Then you have yourself a whole meal. Not an eel, a meal. So you get the guacamole, whoop, and the mashed up bananas, whoop, and some applesauce, whoop, and you eat it. I need something to drink. Lemonade. And there you have it. Hello up there from down here. It's time to be on our bellies. Now, if you are a baby, tummy time is one of the best times of the day. And you can lay your baby on their tummy and help them with moving their hands to the different beat of the song so they can kind of start getting rhythm inside their body and listen to the sound of the song and the lyrics of the song and start getting that in their body. Now, if you're not a baby, then get out of here. Just kidding. If you're not a baby, then you can put yourself on your belly. And that's the best way to do the hammer song, if you ask me, which you did. Well, you didn't, but you did, so. All right, first we gotta get a hammer out. You ready? I'm gonna move back a little so you can see my hammers. Ready? And I'm going to turn sideways so you can see all my hammers. Ready? One, two, three. Now we hammer with one hammer, one hammer, one hammer. Now we hammer with one hammer all day long. What's after one? Two. Now we hammer with two hammers, two hammers, two hammers. Now we hammer with two hammers all day long. What's after two? Right, three. Boing. And if you look really closely, you can see I have donuts on my socks. Do you like donuts? Good. Then this sock's for you. One, two, three. Now we hammer with three hammers, three hammers, three hammers. Now we hammer with three hammers all day long. You're right, four. I didn't even have to ask. Very good. Ready? Now we hammer with four hammers, four hammers, four hammers. Now we hammer with four hammers all day long. What's after four? Right, you just had a birthday, that's how you know. Now you're five. All right, ready for the next one? We have to do a little headbanging. You up for some headbanging? Well, you came to the right place. This is Kid Row after all. Ready? One, two, three, four. Now we hammer with five hammers, five hammers, five hammers. Now we hammer with five hammers all day long. Woo. I'm so tired. But wait, we still have one more song. I mean, one more hammer. Ready? Blech. That is my hair. It's the same color. Hey, hammer six hammers. Now we hammer with six hammers all day long. Bleh. We did it. Good job. Good hammer song today, guys. Whew.
All right, guys, you ready to jam out to your song? Okay, so can you all say, "We're the cement mixers"? Nice. And then can you say, "And this is Hey Mickey"? Nice. Now everyone say, "Hit it, drummer." Awesome job, you guys. Here we go. One, two, one, two, three, four. Oh, Mickey, you're so fine. You're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Oh, Mickey, you're so fine. You're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Oh, Mickey, you're so fine. You're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Oh, Mickey, you're so fine. You're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Mickey.
Freeze dance from the 2000s. So when I stop the music, you stop dancing. Here we go, let's try this out. Did everybody stop? Everybody stop dancing? All right, let's keep going. They're gonna rip it off, taking their time right behind my back. And I'm who froze? Here we go. I hope you paused. I hope you paused. I definitely moved that time. I'm out. Who's gonna keep going? That was a short one. Just seeing if you're on your toes. Don't wanna hear. All right, I'm making it easy because I'm stopping it on the beat. Let's see what happens if I don't stop the next one on the beat. Every single one's got a story to tell. Everyone knows about it. Did you stop? Did you stop? I hope you stopped. Back my way, I'm gonna serve it to you. And that ain't what you want to hear, but that's oh, what I'll do. I tricked you. I didn't stop it. Keep dancing. And the feeling coming from my bones sets my dog We're getting close to the end here. I want to make sure that we're all still dancing here. Are we freezing? All right, we're getting close to the end here. I hope you paused. All right, everybody. So I'm going to be DJing this Friday at 6 p.m. on the Kid Row Instagram. We're going to be doing all these hits from the 2000s, the early 2000s. All right. So if you're around Friday, 6 p.m., come tune in. DJ Ian Sloan. Rock and roll. Kid Row. I hope you caught that last pause.
Okay, guys, class is almost over, but before it is, there's one thing that I really want to teach you guys, and that is practice. Practicing your instruments and your songs are very, very important. Practicing is something that you do when you're learning something new so that you can get good at it. And so, like, for example, if I was learning how to ride a bicycle, I don't just jump on a bicycle and start riding because I don't know how yet. So I get on and I learn about the pedals and I start having someone tell me different things about it that can help, and I work on my balance and I kind of ride my bike a little every day, and then eventually I'm really riding my bike and I know how to do it and I don't even need practice anymore, I just can do it. So the same thing with your songs. I want you guys to listen to your songs over and over and over again so that it gets so in your body and in your brain that it becomes easy to remember. One of the things you can do while you're listening to the song is count the beats. And that way you can, like, in 1, 2, 3, 4, you can kind of get that into your body and that into your system, so that when you go to play your instrument or sing or do whatever you're going to be doing in the band, you're ready and it's already in your body, and then you can focus on what you need to do. Like, for example, if you're the singer, you can focus on the lyrics because you already have the beat and the rhythm going in your body and you already know what's coming next. And then you can also practice your different stage presence stuff with practicing. So once it's in your body, and then you can start, you know what notes to play and stuff, but then you start working on how you're moving your body on stage and all that. So I want you guys to practice, practice, practice. It's the most important thing. Every single band ever in the world has always had to practice over and over and over again. The Beatles were not good as musicians until they practiced like a million times, and then they got really good. And they started in their garage. Garage band, the most original garage band of all time. All right, guys, so what are you gonna do? No, practice!
Hey, cement mixers, who came to rock today? Yeah, you did. 1, 2, 3, 4, who came to rock today?
Today, you guys, we'll see you next week. Bye.
I'll see you next week.
What's up, party animals? It's your boy Bear here at the Kid Row headquarters. I had so much fun rocking out with you guys today and learning all about the bass. Hey, quick question, how many strings are on the bass? You guessed it, 4. What about the guitar? How many strings are on that? Nailed it. 6. Good job, you guys. All right, now it's time to have some fun and get super creative. Let's draw your bases. Don't forget to tune in to Instagram Live this Friday, 6 p.m. DJ Ian Sloan is going to be playing all of our hits from the early 2000s. So bust out those Canadian tuxedos and we'll see you there. All right, guys, rock and roll. See you next week.